Sometimes you just need a little hope, a bite of something encouraging to start your day or smooth out the wrinkles of life. So grab a cup of coffee, take a breath, and let's put a little grace note on the song of our lives. I've written a lot about religion versus relationship. Recently, while trying to explain my thoughts to someone, a picture formed in my mind. You know, religion is about rules and structure. The word itself means belief in and worship of a superhuman controlling power, a personal God. Secondarily, it is a particular system of faith and worship. The Latin root of the word, religio, means to bind. Interestingly enough, there is no Hebrew word for religion, and it's not found in Scripture. What we call religion today was the Mosaic Law given to Moses. Now, relationship is much more warm and fuzzy. The word means the way in which two or more concepts, objects, or people are connected. The state of being connected. The dictionary goes on to define the word as the way two behave or regard each other. Relationship is a flexible and changing thing because people and situations are constantly in flux. It too goes without mention in the Bible. So when you think of the two, religion and relationship, think of a house. The foundation, the joists, the studs, and the rafters are the skeleton for a strong outer shell and foundation, which has to have something built over it. Religion is the framework, and we're that outer structure, the stucco or the paneling or the painting. But inside, it's the moments and the memories that we experience that create a happy home. It's the warmth of those moments that is really what defines relationship. Without that interaction, there might be a strong understructure and a skeleton, and for a time, even a beautiful outer shell, but it will soon fall into disrepair without some kind of care. We all know a structure, no matter how tough, will decay eventually unless it's given constant attention by loving hands. When God sent Jesus to us, He shifted the focus from the framework, all the thou shalt nots, and recognized our human need for the indefinable and emotional inner workings. And it wasn't just for our sake, in my opinion, but because He too craved a more workable relationship with His children. Just because the focus shifted doesn't mean we can have a functional structure without that firm foundation and framework. Christ's sacrifice on the cross didn't wipe out the law. In the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew 5, Jesus said, "Do not think that I came to destroy the law or the prophets. I did not come to destroy, but to fulfill." With His perfect sin-free life and sacrificial death, Jesus perfectly kept both the letter and the spirit of the law and afforded us the opportunity to create a meaningful and personal relationship with our Father. This new relationship allows us to approach God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. We're told that in Hebrews 4:16, throne of grace, not a throne of judgment, not a throne of punishment, a throne of grace. We don't have to timidly worry about every little mistake we make, wondering what kind of sacrifice is needed to atone, and we sure don't have to have an intercessory to fellowship with our dad. Because of the law, the religion, we are given the privilege and the blessing of that kind of relationship. But in the same way that it takes work to keep a house strong and beautiful, it takes an investment of us to keep our relationship with God active and healthy. Remember, relationship is about how two people regard or behave towards each other. Now, God's unchanging, and so is His love and His attitude towards us. We are the ones who lose interest or get sidetracked when things begin to get difficult, or sometimes even when they become too easy. So we must keep investing, talking to God, asking Him the hard questions, and listening for His response. It is said there are five things that keep a relationship alive: trust, respect, love, attention, and communication. That's all our Father is asking from us. Be blessed, my friend. God is on the throne. If you're new to Project Forgiveness or Grace Notes, I hope you'll go to our website at www.projectforgiveness.com. From there, you can send a prayer request or just comment. We want to hear from you. You can also visit us on our YouTube channel or on Facebook at Project Forgiveness. Your thoughts are important, and we care about you. Most of all, we pray that God will richly bless you. And please remember, you are not defined by your worst moment, because God's not finished with you yet.